Hi everyone, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, I'm going to talk about the 6 natural wonders in the world that will give you goosebumps, and that video is going to come up right now. The first one on the list has got to be Angel Falls in Venezuela. The moment my canoe was approaching this natural wonder, which is the world's highest waterfalls, I actually felt emotional inside, bearing witness to this amazing waterfall that is the world's highest waterfall and feeling so insignificant and small, but grateful at the same time that I can witness such beauty in this planet. It's a bit hard to go see Angel Falls because of all the problems happening in Venezuela right now, but if you join a tour company, usually you can get there safely and you can see the world's highest waterfalls. The second one on the list that will definitely give you goosebumps is the Salar Uyuni Salt Flats in Bolivia. They say that this place is where heaven and earth meets, and they're not lying because when you go there, especially during the rainy season between February and April, you can actually see a thin film of water on top of the salt flats that reflect the sky. So you can see this mirror-like image of the sky being on the ground, and it's just mind-blowing. I can't even describe to you how beautiful it is. You have to go there and see it for yourself. It's one of those wonders that I definitely want to see again at some point in the future, even though I've been there already myself, because I missed out doing the starlight tour where you can see the stars reflected on the ground. And that just sounds so incredible to me. The third one on the list is Mount Roraima in Venezuela, which is the highest table mountain in Canaima National Park. And again, this is one of those wonders that you have to trek to. It's about a 6-day trek to complete this whole thing, but it's totally worth it because when you get to the top of this Table Mountain, it's like an alien planet. You also get to camp under a cave-like structure. And if you are creeped out by a cave, then I don't blame you, because when we did camp in that place, there was a tarantula near one of my Russian friend's tent. And thankfully the tarantula left and it didn't bother them at all. So it is a little bit creepy, but the top of this Table Mountain is incredible. They have this area full of quartz, which is super cool. And overall, I think it's just one of those fun adventures to do once in your life. And the good thing is that this Table Mountain is close to the border of Brazil. And in this area, the conflict happening in Venezuela has not been a major problem. So I think a lot of people can still access Mount Roraima, even though there's huge problems happening in Venezuela right now. The fourth one on the list is Kalalau Trail, oftentimes cited as one of the top 10 most dangerous hikes in the world. And mainly because when you're hiking on this trail, you're hiking by the cliffside. So if you make one wrong move and you slip, you can tumble down and get hurt. Or worst case scenario, you can die. Most people are actually okay doing this hike. You just have to watch where you walk. And it's absolutely breathtaking as you see this beautiful cliffside as you are hiking. Do keep in mind that this is a very difficult hike. It's probably one of the hardest hikes I have ever done in my life, because you are bringing a heavy pack up and down this mountain in the blistering heat. Keep in mind, this is in Hawaii, so it's tropical weather, so it's super hot while you're doing your trek. Sometimes there's torrential rain pour as well, which can be a godsend because it helps keep you cool. And also when there's heavy rains, there's less mosquito, which is also another benefit because there's a lot of mosquitoes on this trail. And by the time you get to the end at Kalalau Beach, it is just paradise. And I highly recommend you check out Kalalau Trail because it's definitely one of those natural wonders in the world that will give you goosebumps. Number 5 on the list is the Zion Narrows in Utah. And the Zion Narrows is located in Zion National Park. And basically you are hiking in a slot canyon and you're basically hiking on a river. However, the river is not super deep, so you can easily walk the whole thing. There's only one small section that is quite deep that you might have to swim or tippy toe, depending on how tall you are. I was able to do it tippy toe, but my girlfriend actually had to do a small swim to get through that deep pool area. Regardless, this hike is definitely one of those hikes that you will never forget for the rest of your life, especially because how unique this hike is. Not often you get to hike in water for the whole duration of the trek, and this is one of those rare hikes where you are trekking on water. And finally, number 6 on the list is Antelope Canyon in Arizona. So Antelope Canyon is located in Page, Arizona, and it's this weird place where you can see the beam of the sun coming from the top of this canyon, and it just illuminates this place, giving it a nice effect. You kind of feel like Indiana Jones when you are exploring Antelope Canyon, because it's such a wonderful place. It's great for photographers because you can take some of the best pictures, especially during noontime when the sun is at its highest. There is two Antelope Canyon. There's Lower Antelope Canyon and Upper Antelope Canyon. When I went there, I made a mistake. I only got to see one because I thought there was only one, but later on when I left, turns out there was two. So don't make that mistake. Make sure you check out both Antelope Canyons. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to our Travel and Live free newsletter where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You can also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for that newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.